Assalamualaikum and hi everyone. Are you ready for the next chapter? The third chapter is about electrochemistry. Okay, chapter 3, electrochemistry, is divided into 3. So 3.1 is referred to the galvanic cell, 3.2 is Nernst equation, and 3.3 is electrolytic cell. Okay, for galvanic cell part 1, so for the first part of galvanic cell, you are going to learn about draw a voltaic or galvanic cell, describe the operation of a voltaic cell, and state the function of salt bridge. Electrochemistry is a study of a relationship between electricity and chemical reaction. It involves reduction and oxidation occur at the same time. Reduction and oxidation reaction is also known as redox reaction. Electrochemical cells are divided into 2, galvanic or voltaic cell and electrolytic cell. A galvanic cell or voltaic cell uses a chemical energy released during a spontaneous redox reaction to generate an electrical energy. This type of electrochemical cell is often called a voltaic cell after its inventor, the Italian physicist Alessandro Volta. In a galvanic cell, the cathode is a positive terminal, whereas an anode is a negative terminal. In contrast, an electrolytic cell consumes electrical energy from the external source using it to cause a non-spontaneous redox reaction to occur to derive a chemical energy. In an electrochemical cell, cathode is a negative terminal, whereas anode is a positive terminal. Before we start for the further explanation, so let us recap back what you have already learned during previous secondary school.
What is a reduction reaction? Reduction reaction is a process when a substance such as atom, molecule, or ion gains of electrons. It involves a decreasing of oxidation number. This reaction occurs at the cathode. It also involves gains of hydrogen. For example, copper 2 plus ion is reduced to copper atom by gaining 2 electrons. The oxidation number decreases from positive 2 to 0. Just remember, red cat, reduction at the cathode. What is an oxidation reaction? Oxidation reaction is a process when a substance such as atom, molecule, or ion loses of electrons. It involves an increasing of oxidation number. This reaction occurs at the anode. It also involves gains of oxygen. For example, magnesium atom is oxidized to magnesium 2 plus ion and loses 2 electrons. The oxidation number increases from 0 to positive 2. Just remember, oxyanode, oxidation at the anode.
What is redox reaction? Redox reaction is a process where both oxidation and reduction occur at the same time, where there is a net movement of electron from one reactant, which is reducing agent, to another that is oxidizing agent. Redox reaction is also known as reduction-oxidation reaction. Let us consider the following redox reaction. Can you guess which substance is an oxidizing agent? H plus ion is an oxidizing agent as H plus undergoes reduction. Which substance is a reducing agent? Since zinc undergoes oxidation, thus zinc is a reducing agent.
Oxidation and reduction occur during many chemical changes which involve the transfer of electrons, where one type of this reaction cannot occur without the other. Combustion, cut apple turning brown, rusting of metals, photosynthesis in green plants, fuel combustion in a car are the example of redox reaction occur in our daily life. A galvanic cell is also known as a voltaic cell, which involves a spontaneous redox reaction that generates electrical energy. To understand how a redox reaction occurs in a galvanic cell, let us start with a simple cell that is readily made in the laboratory. A galvanic cell consists of 2 electrolyte solutions that are separated from each other by a salt bridge that allows the flows of ions, in which each end are plugged with a glass wool.
the salt bridge is filled with a salt solution that takes no part in the electrode reaction, such as KCl solution. The anode half cell is a zinc bar which is placed in zinc sulfate solution. The cathode half cell is a copper bar placed in copper sulfate solution. At this combination, it is called a Daniell cell. Both half cells are joined by a circuit which consists of an external wire, a voltmeter, and a bulb. What is the reaction occurs at anode? Since zinc atom is more electropositive than copper atom, zinc has higher tendency to release electrons. Zinc electrodes dissolves and produce zinc 2 plus ions and release 2 electrons. This reaction is called oxidation. The zinc 2 plus ions enter the zinc sulfate solution. As the reaction continues, the excess of zinc 2 plus ions are built up in the zinc sulfate solution. The number of positive and negative charge in anode half cell becomes imbalanced. Therefore, the negative chloride ions migrate from the salt bridge to the zinc sulfate solution and maintain the neutrality of the solution. Now, let us trace the flow of electric current through the cell. At the zinc anode, zinc atoms are oxidized to zinc 2 plus ions and release electrons. This electrode, which pumps electrons into the external circuit, is marked as the negative terminal of the cell. Electrons generated at the anode move through the external circuit to the copper cathode. The electric current flows from the anode to the cathode because there is a difference in electrical potential energy between the electrodes. The difference in electrical potential between the anode and the cathode is measured by a voltmeter. The voltmeter reading is called cell voltage, or also known as electromotive force. The reading are recorded in unit of volt. The cell voltage for this Daniell cell is positive 1.10 watt. If the salt bridge is removed from the half cell, the circuit is broken and the cell voltage becomes 0.00 watt. At the cathode, copper 2 plus ions from copper sulfate solution accept electrons. Copper 2 plus ions are reduced to copper atoms and deposited on the copper electrodes. This reaction is called reduction. The copper electrode which pulls electrons from the external circuit is considered to be the positive terminal of the cell. As the reaction proceeds, the region around the copper electrode tends to become deficient in positive ions as copper 2 plus ions are consumed. To maintain the neutrality, the positive sodium ions migrate from the salt bridge to the copper sulfate solution.